once you've rested.
How do you like the backpack? Is it comfortable? Can you operate stealthily with it? I have a present for you here. A TR rifle. Ring any bells? It's pneumatic, but it still packs a wallop. Plus, making bullets for it is easy as pie, even in the field. Just remember to keep that pressure up. Otherwise, you might as well be spitting him out yourself. Other than that, it will never fail you. I did my best. So, bear it with honor. And don't forget to drop by from time to time. I have a few ideas for improving it.
Thank you, Artyom. If not for you, we'd never have escaped that place. They were so busy looking for you. And then Anna picked us up.
Artyom, I took some measurements. There's one hell of a radioactive hotspot between this place and the port. The readings are off the scale.
So you better take a boat.
Yes, Artyom.
We found one and docked it under the bridge.
And your wife is great. She's kind, really strong. Thank you, Artyom.
There you go, Artyom. As I always said, you lucked out with me.
We all lucked out with Anna. She's a total deadeye. Now I only wish your mom could come with us too. With a real medic, we'd become unstoppable.
I could replace the cylinder, but there's just no spare. I've got to fix this one. And I don't even know where to start. It usually takes a whole workshop to fix things like this.
Hi, Artyom.
Hello again, Artyom. You did great out there. Or so everyone says. In the meantime, we have dug in here. We've been waiting for the occupying forces. But so far, we've only seen winged and four-legged ones. Or it's always been to see family with them.
Thank you. Братуха, that was crazy! Блин, those mutants are pretty hardcore. The villagers are never have a chance against them. You just cut through them, блин. Well, it's pleasure to meet you. Name's Crest, by the way. Are you from the train? Bet the locals wouldn't even talk to you guys. Opened fire right away, didn't they? Of course, those dumb bastards. I've been here long enough to know the drill. They have a cult over there. The dumbasses are hung up on technology having destroyed the old world. So they don't exactly take kindly to smart guys here. And me, they were just gonna lock me up until I agreed to go fight those electrical demons of theirs to absolve my sins. Because I was in cahoots with Satan, apparently, блядь. Some Satanist I am. I've been fixing engines and trading all my life. Now I'm moving to the east. Blin, I'm sick of this part of country. There's just nothing to do here anymore. The cities are gone. Bandits, beasts all around. Lots of space across the Volga, though. Plenty of opportunity. So I came here with my rail car full of trading goods, hoping to make a few sales on the way east. What a fool I was. I was lucky to get out alive. Anyway, since you've arrived, I've been thinking of this little plan I had, never had a chance to pull off alone, but since you guys are also going east... Now, judging by what I could see with my binoculars, it's a miracle your engine is still running. Oh, by the way, take the binoculars. I'll show you where everything is. Look at the bridge first. See that section on top? It should lower if the emergency mechanism still works. Katya from the church should know better. I've never been to the bridge myself. There, to the right, that huge hangar. That's a terminal, blin. The cultists consider it a holy place. Covered it all in graffiti, schmaffiti. Their tsarfish lived there, you know? Stupid bastards. Even further right, see the building near all those carriages? Used to be a train depot. There are some bandits there now, but the place itself ain't bad. Oh, the area nearby isn't too bad either. There's a good hunting and stuff. I set up several safe camps around there. If you find them, you could rest, fix your equipment, unless you prefer spending nights at an open campfire. Now, come on, let me show you my home now. Here is my cave. And this is where I live. Not a palace, one. Oh, here's a bed. So if you're tired, My home is your home. I made a workbench to tinker on. If you need ammo or grenades, there's some raw materials here. So help yourself. You can have anything you like here. Can't carry all the shit anyway. Come on, don't be shy. Oh, anyhow, gotta tell you, this isn't just a pretty face. I've got a whole lot of knowledge stored up in here. And look at these hands. They know how to fix stuff. You'll never have second thoughts about picking me up. Managed to buy some smokes from the villagers before the assholes chased me away, but... Now, you could take the zipline down. Just hook up and away you go. Dumb cretins didn't like my light. Yeah, I've been banned from the village and the bridge ever since. Ah!
Artyom, I heard you call me. It was so great there. But I heard you and couldn't leave you.
Thank you.
Found me.
Oh, what is this place?
See the barrels? They're chemicals of some kind. This place is either for storage or it's a dump. And that short could have been put there by the locals to mark the spot.
Thank you, my love.
Oh, okay, all right. So, Artyom, let's pick her up now?
No way in hell. I can walk just fine. I'll just rest a bit and get going.
The old man's probably going seven sorts of crazy now, thinking his precious daughter got hurt or something.
Dad, it's me. My radio battery died. I got it wet. Other than that, I'm fine. Artyom and the guys are here.
Sam, it's a view. Thanks for coming by foot. Now I want you to drag her butt here with extreme prejudice. Time to talk some sense into that brat. Japan's asking for some too. Try to get civilians on board. Everyone's gone nuts here.
Head back. Help Stepan persuade my father about letting Katya and Nastya travel with us. Artyom, I am feeling better now. Really, I am.
So, Sam, tell me what the real enemy bases look like so that we know when we see it.
Well, first of all, these huge humanoid robots, all plastered with stripes, with nuclear reactors up their asses.
Artyom, help us here. The old man won't let Katya...
We have to go back now, I guess.
Well, hi, Artyom. All right, welcome to the crew.
Well...
Thank you. Won't let you down.
I don't know.
Hey, Artyom, see how it all worked out?
Come here, Artyom. Have a seat. Look, we have an opportunity to cross the bridge without an assault. There are trade caravans going up the river, and the bridge dwellers do business with them. So, disguised as such traders, we will infiltrate the bridge and lower it. Katya says it still works. They won't be able to stop us if we move fast. And should they try, we'll cross it no matter what those fanatics think. They want blood, they will get it. So now, we only have to wait for the traitor's boat.
Colonel, sir, we can't just leave them here. They will be eaten alive.
Stepan, did you ever try using your head? Do you know where we are going? What we are going to face on the way there? Where, pray tell, are they going to sleep on the Aurora? Atop the coal crates? We Spartans can handle it. But for a woman, with a 6-year-old daughter, no less, this is unacceptable.
I'll give them my bedroll and move into the stokehold.
You will fall asleep and get your throat cut the next day you get guard duty after trying to sleep there.
Still, I know we can't leave them.
Let's just collect that carriage Katya told us about while we wait. We can't leave the child here. And anyhow, how long are we going to sleep in turns for?
Are you starting that again? How, huh? How are we going to collect that carriage? I'm not taking the Aurora there.
Oh, you don't need it. I have a rail car hidden in a terminal. It can tow a carriage like nobody's business. Artyom and I can go get it and bring the carriage back.
No way I'm letting you go. It'll take us both till morning to finish the repairs, and I can't handle it myself in time.
Okay, okay, have it your way. I'm done playing the monster here. We get that carriage. We take the civilians with us. Artyom, will you handle this? Listen, Artyom, if the caravan is sighted, drop everything and rush to the port. It's our best chance of traversing the bridge.
Thanks, Dad. Katya and Nastya will be so grateful.
Here, Artyom, it's a breaker for the rail car. It won't run without this. She's a real babe, Artyomich, no two ways about it. We went to hell and back, her and I. So much stuff we hauled, so many tight spots she saved me from. Look, Artyom, since you're going to the terminal, hear me out. It's quite a distance away, and look, if you go at night, there's less of a chance you might run into bandits. They stay at their camps when it's done. But it's not gonna be easy either, since more beasts come out, and there are also electrical anomalies. The fanatics call them the demons of electricity, so you should think about your options before heading out.
Artyom, Duke is on a mission in that area. He's keeping tabs on the bridge. Reception is bad there. We get mostly static from him. Anyway, if you meet him, he'll update you on the latest developments in the terminal. I bet you've conspired with Anna and Stepan. I care for those two no less than you. But we don't know if what's ahead is any better than the fanatics. I guess we'll have to live and see.
Great job persuading the old man. Check out my setup here, Artyom. I finally got everything the way I wanted. A proper workbench, with storage space for all my tools, and some to spare. You can clean your weapons and make ammo for them here, just like with any other workbench you might find. My gun rack is only available here on the Aurora, though. I'll keep samples of every gun you find, and you can exchange them whenever you want. Always in their best working condition. Oiled and shiny like new. You won't have to install any attachments again, though. I'm going to make you all competent gunsmiths eventually. Listen, Artyom, I have something for your Tihar. You can try installing it. Use the workbench. Well, I won't keep you here any longer.
Anna, thank you and Artyom for helping us. I don't know what would have become of us without you. It is a cursed place. And that's Silentius.
Artyom, are you going to the terminal? You might meet Duke there. He's got an observation post set up in a carriage near the bridge. Ask him for a sit rep before going in. One more thing. That tower to the right, see it? There's someone over there. I think it's the bandits. They're watching us.
We heard someone playing guitar over there. Those guys can't play for shit. Stepan wanted to take the instrument from them. They were torturing the melody.
Artyom, Nastya has something she wants to ask you. Go on, Nastya.
Uncle Artyom, will you find my teddy?
There, that wasn't so hard. See, there are demons nesting somewhere on those storage tanks near the terminal. So could you check if the toy is on one of them? I know this sounds silly, but it was a present from her father, and she doesn't want to leave without it. Look, I'll be in your debt if you do. Oh, and don't do anything risky, of course. One more thing. I heard the guitar coming from that tower. It had a nice sound, but the player, oh, he's just atrocious. I know it's dangerous and all, but if a chance presents itself, save the instrument.
Hey! What are you people doing? Turning our main frequency into a call show? He's got a mission! Don't pile stupid shit on top of it!
Oh, Colonel, sir, we're done already.
I'm just too nice to you all. All right, as you were. Over and out.
Hmm.
Well, hello, my blood brother. Didn't see me, huh? The others don't either. I'm basically part of the scenery now. I heard you were headed to the terminal for the rail car. Then let me fill you in. The terminal can only be entered by water. Luckily, there is a dock with a boat nearby, left there by the fanatics, it seems. Inside there are just those, humanimal mutants, or so it seems. See that gas station? It's a bandit hideout. They ambush the fanatics. These guys seem to be drawn to the terminal like flies to you-know-what. The bandit caught three of them on my watch. Look at the building over there. Bandits keep captives there for ransom or something. But they sure go to town on the poor guys. I asked the colonel for permission to go in three times, but no dice. I understand why, but we have always protected common folk from lowlifes like these. So I'm having a hard time staying put. Oh well. See those ruins? There's a bandit camp there too. They have a sniper. I saw at least one scope flashing from the roof. So I wouldn't advise an open attack. The bridge is in full lockdown. None of the armed dudes ever show themselves. They definitely expect us to attack, so there is no reason to be concerned about them now. Hey, it's your choice when to move out, but the bandits should be easier to avoid in the dark. In any case, I'm going back to my post.